So first, we're going to look at problem 14 from 6.3. And we have a continuous rate of 2.75%. And part A asks us to find the APY of the account. So to find the APY, we first need to identify our growth factor. Well, if we have a continuous rate of 2.75%, then e to the 0.0275 gives us our growth factor. The reason that's important is if we can identify our growth factor to get the growth rate, all we have to do is subtract 1 and turn it into a percent. Calculating this out gives us 2.788%. So anytime we need the APY, first thing is remember how to find your growth factor, then subtract 1 and multiply by 100. Part B asks, what would the nominal rate have to be if we had an account compounding quarterly to have the same APY? So we saw that our APY was 2.788%. Well, what we're going to do in this is compare growth factors. So the growth factor for the APY in part A was e to the 0.0275. Now, a growth factor for a rate compounded quarterly would be 1 plus the rate, which is what we're looking for, over the number of times it's compounded, so 4, raised to the 4. So this is the equation we need to solve for R. We're just setting the two growth factors equal to each other. To solve for R, first thing we'll do is we'll raise both sides to the 1/4. So that gives us e to the 0.0275 divided by 4 equals 1 plus r over 4. Next, we'll subtract 1 off of each side. So e to the 0.0275 over 4 minus 1 equals r over 4. Last step, multiply both sides by 4, and we will get our nominal rate, which to 3 decimals is 2.759%. So that would be our rate times 100%, sorry. The other one we had in this homework quiz was number 36, also from 6.3. In 36, we were given two different rates and asked to compare them. We had a 5.1% compounded monthly and 5.07% compounded daily. Basically, we just need to compare either growth factors or APYs. So first off, a growth factor for 5.1% compounded monthly is going to be 1 plus 0.051 over 12. To the 12. That comes out to be 1.052209. So this one has an APY of 5.22%. The growth factor for 5.07% compounded daily is 1 plus the rate as a decimal, so 0.0507, there's 365 days in a year, and it has to also be raised to the 365. This growth factor came out to be 1.0520035. We now have enough information actually to answer this question. This has the greater growth factor, so 5.1% compounded monthly has a higher APY, or is going to give us a better return every year. The APY in our second, if we wanted to go ahead and calculate it, is 5.20%.